Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion Blind for the Amiga. I am Amethyst Lunatari. We got some stuff on the ground here. Guess we're looting the bodies who we just killed at the end of our... Well, killed the last one at the end of last episode. Oh, we got some more of these grenades. Excellent. He was having fun with this stuff. More axe grenades. Audio code card. Okay, so this thing's loaded. Oh, and I have to thank Matko. You can switch the hands. I'll show you in the next battle, but when I was, sorry, I forgot the last name. Matko. M-A-T-K-O. Thank you for the little tip. When you're in combat, two hands will show up on either side. You can click one of those hands to make it the active hand, so this way you don't have to switch. Like, I kept switching things into the other hand. By the way, I have to get him with something. So, like, if this ran out of ammo and we had a knife here, I would spend a move to put the knife into the right hand and put this in the backpack. We don't have to do that. We can just switch to the other hand. They're ambidextrous, not right-handed. Alright, so... I want to switch his stuff around, and I want to look at what we got, so... This is probably nothing... great. I just want to see what it might say, if anything. Audio code card! 0.05 kilograms. Alright, that's it. One item, we got a little bit of text with it, so I just want to make sure if there's a second item, we see it. Alright, so we can put that back in there. Who's holding this thing? Is that it? No. It wasn't the Beast 4. Call can carry that thing. Shotgun. All right, there's only one more person who could have it then. That's it. I just want to reload it. It's a loaded weapon now, so... I'll give it that to Killdozer then. Or should I just let Epsilon have it? He could got a lot of attacks off of that thing. Because he gets a lot of attacks off of everything. This is more ammo. Oops. That's just spare grenade. Yeah, so it just has one spare grenade. And as far as this, yeah, it's got two ammo in it, and another two ammo here. So he needs a regular knife. Oh, it's a two-handed weapon. Put it in there then. Okay. Now it's like, what are you saving for already? Because in case we die, I don't have to do all this again. 37 run. Alright, so, yeah, I've been fighting with a little bit of a handicap because I've been spending rounds to move equipment back and forth between hands when I can actually use either hand. I'll show you what I mean to you. I go into another combat, but there's basically a hand here and it shows an item, and then there's a hand that way, shows an item. You can click on the hand itself. I thought it was just part of the interface, the artwork. It wasn't part of the interface, but rather the artwork. Okay. Security lock gate. Enter only with a valid permission. To the east. Security lock gate. Do not proceed without a valid audio card. Gateway B to security chamber. Wait. Audio code 200. Stuff. Audio code 0806-1968. Weird music. Oh, we gotta use that audio card there. That's another audio code. Well, that's interesting. Oh, this? Oh, we died! Glad I saved. A strong, sweet smell overwhelms you as the security chamber activates a large dose of a prohibited military nervine gas called claw. This is the last thing you recognize before everything goes dark. How do we recognize the smell of it? I had no idea that was going to happen, guys, but I'm just used to dying in this game. I know I'm supposed to use the audio card, but I don't know which door I'm supposed to use it on. A red message on the grating says tower section, no trespassing. So he's supposed to use this audio card here, or is that just not go anywhere? probably supposed to go to that machine and use it there. Nothing special happens at all. Is it you that has the other stuff? Well, I don't think this thing stuff's gonna work, but just in case. We gotta go back and mess with this card. Back all the way past all the storerooms here. Audio card sound sample generator. Oh, we need a code. I don't know if we need to die. 01071373. Oh! We don't need the code then. The period. The card contains now the audio sample code that you have just entered. Now there were other codes, so I don't know. I see. It's probably still going to send the gas through, but we have to use the card in time. Security lock gate. I didn't see anything with 0107-1973. Correct. Gateway A enabled. You may enter now. Huh. This bare place must be that security chamber. It's the other side of all this. Organism detector. Alright. Could be a battle up ahead. Alright. Oh, not battle. Not yet. Now battle. Hello there? Oh no. It must be only a bad dream. Witchmasters of Carnivore. Well, your intuition has always been telling you that until now, it was far too easy. So you'd better expect the worst. And now it is here. After all, who else shall guard the security chamber of a Carnivore High Priest than the specially conditioned assassins of his order? During their cool training in the southern caverns of Eclipse, these soulless evil beings slowly become blind, deaf, and mute. But in exchange, their inner sight sharpens to an almost supernatural level, where the perfect harmony between spirit and flesh guides them into the ancient art of murder. Well, they're mute. Obviously, they're not going to talk, but we'll get a funny message. Hey, don't you remember? These witchmasters do not use verbal communication. Same. Now the interesting thing is, I kind of wonder if they got the idea from a novel called Black Wind by F. Paul Wilson. Read it not too long ago. There's three of them. Reconnoiter here. Alright, so he should only be visible to one of these people. And he's using... So... where are we? He's using a grenade launcher. Cool. So the thing about the Black Wind... It was used... Well, they used something called... I don't remember exactly. They had done this to children, which is the part of the book I really didn't like. They basically would remove all five senses, including touch and smell, I believe. They'd remove the touch by severing their spinal cord in such a way. It was horrible. I think I had a nightmare about it after reading that. But yeah, they would basically... The children would go insane because they were basically floating through a formless void. They were just like pure consciousness at this point. Oh, here's where you can switch it. So thank you to Matco for that. We can switch to whatever we want and it's not costing any action points or anything like that. So you know what? Have anything? Oh, he has the Scorpion machine gun. Oh, that's his... Okay. Well, that's a little confusing because... I mean, it makes sense. Right hand on the right. Left hand on the left. But then when you look here... The right hand is here and the left hand is here, so this should have been switched. That's not a big deal. So they would basically, through that, they would create this black wind somehow that would basically destroy everything in its path that was living, even down to bacteria. And they kind of explored that, or he, the author, explored that a bit more in another novel called By the Sword. But at that point, they used a homeless man instead of children, so it was a little easier. Still, don't want to be doing that to homeless people, but I think it was only one. Meanwhile, they had all these children abducted. It was a really good novel, Black Wind, but that was horrible. So I was kind of wondering if he's influenced by that, and I think that came out in the late 80s, that novel, so definitely fall in line before. Well, we got places to hide from them. He's still got a limit on his speed. I think we're gonna break the limit today. What's his speed at? 1485. We're gonna break it in this battle, I believe, to where he's pretty much unlimited. What's he using? I mean, you know what's really good? They're lined up, aren't they? I mean, obviously they're gonna stay lined up. So if we can switch this to a tunnel of life force drain. And then, how do we get back out? Is it still selected, or did we abort that out? Hold on a second. Oh. Well, it wouldn't switch me back. Try again. Okay, here we go. So this is a little risky for him to do. And you're using this plasma. Plasma Gemini plasma laser. I gotta keep him back here. He can't really go far. And what is he using? Oh, that boomerang. I guess that's fair to use. Maybe I'll switch him to a spell as well? I wish losing one party member wasn't a deal breaker. what I meant to do. Here we go. I'm not gonna use it yet. Alright, he's got this thing. Oops. Diffused glare? Oh, he had his own friend. Hormonal spray? Injured by some kind of organic materials. I mean, it's like what the vampires used. Malevolent. He stands paralyzed under destructive mental influence? Okay, using the machine gun. Oh, that got him good. Tunnel of life force strain. So it should hit all of them. Well, unless it misses. Got that one. I only hit one? Disappointing. Missed. Oh. Ah, crap, I did it again. He's not gonna have enough points to refill or reload his weapon. We have to defend this round. That was a mistake. Obviously, a mental defense is in order. Oops. I keep forgetting what everyone has. Okay, he has this plasma laser. How are we doing? Okay, so far. Speed is good. All right, let's go again with the Tunnel of Life Force train. One on the end. He might be out of ammo for this, I'm not sure. Oh no, there's plenty. I guess maybe I should be hitting with the life force drain on him. He's got a blast of it. Own claw hit. Extreme light. A malevolent something of suicidal. I can't read it. You cannot target anything. Your perception is extremely low. Epsilon? Oh, crap. Perception. I don't have anything that can cure that. Let's go with the life force drain. This is with the blast of life force drain. This guy in the end. You can't do anything, can you? He misses with his spells, he misses with his gun. Maybe the middle one will die. Maybe the last one will die. Nice. Let's have a run back and forth, get the speed up. Right. Reloading. The malevolent obsession of a suicidal maniac, says my note. Storm of hormonal spray. Hit himself. These people are not too bright. Empty. Ah. I gotta reload first. It's not gonna let me, is it? I gotta stop doing that. Well, the only thing bad here about this tunnel, it's gonna hit our friend, so. Maybe he should focus on healing? Thank you. affected. Good. Ooh. Alright, this is the blast again. Oh, he can't target him, can he? That one's dead. Oh, I don't know why I went in here. Stop missing. He does need it. Well, that's the limit of his range here. Casting on himself, too. Now I can't reach anyone else, so... Oops. Alright, never mind then. He's using that boomerang. I don't know if he can even reach, but... Please hit Varanus. Please hit with somebody. Hit somebody. Wait a second. A blast of life force drain. Can you hit this guy on the end? Can we get them both, maybe? No, it only hit one. Did it hit one of them? Let's get our speed up a little more. He might have unlimited speed with the next battle. Epsilon injured. I think, yeah, he needed to reload, didn't he? Here we go. Weapon. Okay, never mind. Felt like throwing a grenade would be fun. Oops. Missed. Missed. Awesome. Hit these people. I know it works on them. Because rune claws worked on them. I guess, yeah, they do get to go twice around. They get to go at the beginning and the end of the round. Awesome. I think we have one more round in it. No, we don't. Oh, I did. I keep doing it. What the hell is wrong with me? Do I have enough action time to... No. Alright, so... I mean, he's pretty much fine. He'll just stand there and be a bullet sponge for a little bit. There's only one guy here. Can't reach with the boomerang, no. Sometimes it sticks. Yeah, it's definitely stuck there. Okay. Oh, I have him on the wrong. Hopefully just delaying the inevitable. We don't have our weapons. Moonclaw not lined up correctly. Well, if Uranus will hit at once, he'll take out his vitality, which is only at 9, so let's see if that can happen. Nope. You stink, Varanus. What the hell's wrong with you? I don't like you with this stamina, so I'm afraid you're gonna have to go hide now. He has 16. Wow, you have 16 stamina and mental energy. I don't think it really casts anything. Yeah, vitality 9. But... oh, it did lower his vitality a little bit. Can't see what it's at, it's just that's lower. Trying to separate him from the others a little bit. So these area effect things won't get us. Healed by Advent, actually. Just go where Advent can see him, and then do that. Oh, crap, he can't do it. 35. He's out of the range there. He's out of the running. The boomerang, right. Ah, this might be it. Yay! Throw in a little extra speed. Because we're so happy we defeated them, and it didn't take over an hour to do so. Oh yeah, he's gonna be unlimited. Alright. There's an object here. We will check it out next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.